This work presents a neural network-based framework for estimating key point position uncertainty in visual odometry. Feature-based frame-to-frame pose estimation makes use of identifying corresponding key points in two images. Noisy key point positions lead to small errors in the estimated pose. Accounting for this noise distribution was shown to lead to better pose estimates by focusing on key points with less positional noise. However, not all key point extractors exhibit the same noise distribution, such that there is no unified model for key point uncertainty. Our framework learns noise distribution for any key point extractor by making use of differentiable nonlinear least squares. DNLS allows our framework to train a neural network directly from pose estimation errors. The so obtained covariances lead to better pose estimates and reduced long-term pose drift in a visual odometry setting. Estimating the pose between two images is a long-standing problem in computer vision. Feature-based approaches use corresponding key points and geometric constraints, such as the epipolar constraint, to optimize the pose. Not all corresponding key points are equally well suited to accurately estimate the pose, as key point positions exhibit small errors. Recent literature has modeled this small error as random Gaussian noise in the image plane and derived a probabilistic optimization scheme accounting for this uncertainty. Accounting for the key point uncertainty in the optimization leads to reduced drift in tasks such as visual odometry. To use this probabilistic approach, the uncertainty of the key points has to be correctly estimated. However, key point extractors exhibit different error distributions, leading to the necessity of modeling the noise distributions for each key point extractor individually, as done by previous literature work. To address the difficulty of correctly modeling the uncertainty, we propose a data-driven framework that works for any key point extractor, using a deep neural network to predict the positional uncertainty directly from the images. Our network learns to predict a dense uncertainty map from images. Combined with key point predictions, this produces key points with their corresponding uncertainty estimate, which can be used in the aforementioned probabilistic normal epipolar constraint optimization. We train our network through differentiable nonlinear least squares directly from the pose estimation error. The nonlinear least squares formulation of the PNEC allows us to use implicit differentiation to determine the gradient of the pose error with regard to uncertainty estimates, which is then used to train the network to predict better positional uncertainties that reduce the pose estimation error. As the PNEC focuses on optimizing the rotation of the poses, we only use the rotational error as a training signal. Training on the rotational error requires datasets with accurate pose information to compare our estimated poses against the ground truth data. Obtaining such datasets is challenging and significantly reduces the available data for our training. To address this, we propose an alternative training strategy that replaces the two-frame pose error with the cycle consistency between a tuple of images to approximate the pose error. This enables our framework to be trained fully self-supervised without the need for ground truth pose information. We evaluate the gradient we obtained from implicit differentiation in synthetic experiments to demonstrate its capability to derive meaningful covariance estimates. For this, we sample individual pose estimation problems using a known noise distribution for key points in an image plane. Starting from an estimate of uniform noise distributions, we update our noise estimates directly using the gradient. The experiments show that following this gradient leads to a lower pose estimation error and correctly identified noise distributions in the image plane. For more details, please refer to the paper and the supplementary material explaining the need for diverse data. Our whole framework is evaluated on real-world data. we train networks on the KITTI dataset to predict key point positional uncertainty for superpoint and a KLT tracker as key point detectors representing learned and classical approaches. For both detectors, we evaluate our supervised and self-supervised training strategies. All networks are trained on sequences 0 to 7 on the KITTI dataset and evaluated on sequences 8 to 10. As a network architecture, we choose a UNet as it allows us to incorporate high and low level information. We compare our predicted covariances to both non-probabilistic post-estimation algorithms and the PNEC with different uncertainty estimates from the literature. There is no key point uncertainty estimation for superpoint, so we use the superglue matching confidence as a stand-in approximation. All of the shown methods use the same key point detections. Networks trained in a supervised and self-supervised manner both outperform the other pose estimation techniques regarding rotation and translation estimation. The learned covariances generalize well to unseen data in a test split of the KITTI odometry dataset. This can be seen in qualitative trajectories as well as in quantitative metrics. They do not only consistently perform better than non-probabilistic methods, but also probabilistic ones. This indicates that our learned covariances more accurately model the key point uncertainty distribution than previous methods. Our framework also allows us to estimate uncertainty for key point detectors not covered by literature work, such as superpoint. This video presented a framework for training neural networks to estimate key point uncertainty for visual odometry through differentiable nonlinear least squares. Our framework offers a data-driven approach to uncertainty estimation for any key point detector, making it extremely versatile. Thank you so much for your attention. If you are interested in more experiments, such as evaluations on the EuRoC dataset, or more detailed explanations of our framework, please visit our project page for the paper and supplementary material.